minutes of the game.
Everybody's kind of trying to scale up. They just had vision control of the areas, and the impact of the junglers just, they were kind of just outplaying each other. It was like, we're just going to roam around, we're going to have some conflict, but there was never really a big engaged team fight that somebody forced out. And a lot of that is TSM didn't have engaged tools until they were around Dragon and could get a choke point with Orianna.
How much of that, too, is the fact that the series is 1-1, so both teams not wanting to give up that advantage and, pushing it to series point?
I guess both teams could be kind of in the mindset of, okay, I don't want to screw up, but I don't know. They might just be tired, mentally fatigued from the two games already, which have been pretty action-packed.
And of course, we did see TSM give that Zed back to high, which he's illustrated he has confidence and, the playmaking abilities on that champion to bounce back from a not so great game in the second game.
Yeah, the exact same bans from Cloud9 and the first pick from game one, which was so successful from them before. They just went back to an old strategy there. And Hai, he really looks back to form this playoffs. We talked about it. His regular season wasn't that fantastic. Now that the meta's kind of back in this assassin area, he's really flourishing on things like Yasuo, which he didn't have a great game on. But his Zed looks on point, and I think it needs to be banned on red side every time.
I want to point out that he got like rolling this game the exact same way he got in the first game, which was he went top and he got a kill on Darius without using either summoner spell.
Yeah, that's definitely helpful when you're playing an assassin like Zed. This time, though, we did see Bjergsen hop onto the Orianna as opposed to the Fizz, and I, even with the loss, I do feel like that worked out a bit better for him. Was that kind of what you think he should have gone for there, Poboether?
In terms of the mid pick, Orianna was fine, but the problem was that they have this super supportive team comp with Orianna Lulu, and Turtle was constantly getting in like these really weird positions. Like that last fight, he rocket jumped into the Maokai and then just pretty much got killed by Zed instantly.
And then, of course, Zyrene, you pointed out that they didn't have a ton of engage opportunities, and Cloud9 was able to take advantage of that by really stalling out for the engagement they wanted. And we are going to actually take a quick look at that replay of the misclicked Zhonyas there from Dyrus 28 minutes into the game. Zyrene, talk to me a little bit about maybe what was the impetus for this, and perhaps it just is a misclick.
I think it's a misclick. There's no reason for him to Zhonyas there. There was no skill shots coming in on him. It could be nerves. It could be the fact that he had bought it just a couple minutes ago and hadn't put it on the key that he was expecting. So we're going to roll it out here. And I don't want to belabor it too much, but he was just in a bad position and he ends up hitting it. And yeah, maybe meant to hit a potion. Maybe it could have been a masterful bait by Dyrus that didn't go the right way. But regardless, it tells Cloud9 that they get to go in. Wild Turtle ends up getting popped there. Man, Dyrone tearing this family apart.
Well, it just kind of also illustrates how much this game can change on the on a dime.
I've never seen a single misplay like that affect a game that's been so even before, because that ended up giving them Dragon, gives them Baron. It's what they ended up rotating to right after that. And Cloud9, they got that just big gold lead for themselves, but it's still very low in kills, very low contact game.
And then, of course, Poebelter, just as a player who's played in high-pressure situations, and I will call you out for the one time that you actually flashed a wall and Zhonyas.
Yeah.
When that happens in a game, though, how does that affect your mentality as a player, just making, an honest mistake like that?
Well, when that happened, I did the exact same thing versus Curse, like, in the middle of the split. It actually really shattered my mentality. Like, I thought we were going to lose the game off that play. Like, luckily we were still able to win, but I was just, like, really on tilt. I was quiet, and I didn't play as well.
Yeah, and when I was talking about how it's a low-contact game, just going back to my point, because I didn't actually completely close it out, I'm sorry about that. Because it's such a low-contact game in kills, the objectives are worth even more, because that's where you're going to get your advantages. Because Cloud9, they don't have any wave clear aside from Zed using his shadow and just doing that, but Orianna has more, so it's more of a wave clear, stall it out on Cloud9 or TSM side, and then look for Cloud9 to engage on you. But Cloud9 was looking for the engages that don't happen always under turret. They're looking for the dragon fights, so it was always kind of like 7 minutes, 6 minutes. We'll see every dragon fight, every Baron fight, back and forth, and that's where the action was going to originate. But you had to get vision control first, so teams were that didn't have the vision would just back off, say you can have it this time, we'll come back for it. So I think the objective trading really shows how on level these two teams are with each other.
And of course, Cloud9 then decided to use their engage opportunities throughout the rest of the game to pick up that victory. We're going to jump to the final team fight, the ace that secures the victory for them. We're going to pull that up onto your screen here. And Poe Belter, I'm going to have you walk us through this one.
So this was, we can roll the clip. This was the fight I was talking about where Turtle jumps in and ends up getting caught out by Zed. He gets rooted, Zed is coming in and eventually catches up with his shadow jump. So the fight is like pretty much a 4v5 instantly. The Oriole doesn't deal that much damage because of the locket. And then from here, they're so split up. Zed picks off Tristana. Kha'Zix is trying to help. And it just puts them all in such a bad position. Maokai gets a catch on Lust Boy. And from here, they're just picking them off. Because the Assassinate at the very beginning of the fight, that just already spells the game.
Yeah, it was off the back of a crit, too. And the only crit item he had in his inventory was Yomu's Ghostblade.
And it was such an incredibly bold jump in there by Tristana. I'm not entirely sure what was going through his head there to jump in towards a Maokai.
It's Wild Turtle.
Well, yeah, and that was going to be my question, is that he is known for making some of those aggressive plays like that. Whose job is it on the team to kind of temper that for him and reel him in? Because sometimes it pays dividends when he goes aggressively, but at other times it can be the catalyst for an entirely lost team fight.
It's kind of a toss-up there, because Bjergsen is the shot caller of the team. Amazing is in charge of the ganks in the early game. But Lustboy, his lane partner, you know, he moderates him through the lane, so Wild Turtle really needs to check himself there. I really think that it needs to be his decision-making, or at least his communication with the team, saying, I'm going here, or at least getting feedback and saying, should I go? I really think that's the problem there. Communication is very key.
I think he just kind of went for a risky play there. They didn't have any vision on Baron or the surrounding area, so I think he assumed that the four other members on TSM were, I mean, the four other members on C9 were on Baron, and that Balls was just out of position, so he went in to pick him off, but that wasn't the case, and he just got punished so hard for it.
Illustrating the importance of vision. Well, TSM is currently locking down their game plan going into Game 4, so what exactly is it that they need to be discussing right now? What are going to be the key factors in coming out with a victory?
I think just don't get down on yourself, Dyrus, for the Zhonya's play. I think that's a really big one. And also, their pick bans, what they're going to do about the Zed and Syndra now.
I think that they'll just lean to comfort picks. Well, it's either they're going to lean to their comfort picks or they're going to just do something crazy because they feel like they have no hope. So
I'd like to see something crazy. Well, we'll find out. Don't touch that mouse. Cloud9 are just one win away from becoming our Summer Split Champions. When we come back, it's on to Game 4 of Team Solo Mid versus Cloud9. Our Championship Monday continues. 3.5.